This is a half drone built in real life. The goal of this project is to balance the half drone as stable as possible as a final video of the PID control series. Wait, do you hear that? The fluctuating whir of the motors. It's like music to me. That's my PID controller in action, meticulously adjusting the motor's RPM. Now, let's dive in to see how I did it. Previously, we played around with the half-drone game on the web to intuitively understand how a PID controller works. Then I went over Python code to implement the PID controllers. So, next step is to build one in real life, obviously. To build a half-drone in real life, I've designed the frames and printed them. Then I have prepared aluminum bar, carbon fiber tube, bearings, and bolts and nuts. Then I assembled one, and the total time took about 30 minutes or so. For the electronics, I ran into actually several issues like soldering and then mismatched male and female plugs and so on. I totally missed to record all these electronic parts. Despite that, this is the final version. Next, I roughly wrote a code in Arduino. Why rough? Short answer is that I'm lazy. A bit longer answer is that I just wanted to demonstrate PID code, not the sensor fusion code. Without the sensor fusion, the estimated angle from drone would be full of noise as well. But I think it's okay for now, hopefully. As you notice, the sensor values are all raw values. I used a couple of low-pass filters to reduce the noise of the angles and angular velocity. Then, like before, I defined the error first. Based on the error, now I can calculate the output using the idea of the PID controller. The reason why I limit the output or u_int in the code is not to overshoot too much, as I will be running it on my desk. I didn't want to cut my face with the propellers and so on. Then the rest of the code blocks are for the functionalities of starting and stopping the controller.
Okay, I think this drone is kind of working, but not really perfect, and that's because the noise from the sensor is just directly fed into the controller algorithm. And we haven't really done anything about the sensor fusion or noise reduction. So this is kind of a natural behavior of it, but the idea of the PID controller is the same as before.
So, to wrap up, in the real-world scenario, PID is very simple to implement. However, its assumption is that the measured values, like angle and angular velocities, need to be very accurate. In other words, crap in, crap out. Instead, it's quite intuitive and handy algorithm that anyone can implement one, so you should use one too.
Okay, I think that's it for now. If you also enjoy diving into these kind of concepts, please take a moment to like the video and then subscribe to the channel. Your support means a lot to me. That's it for now. I'm Elliot. I'll see you in the next video.